We're about to work out. We're running. What are we running? Like about 7 miles.
7 miles a day. It was a lot. Guys, Rob put me on this chicken that somebody made. Just ate a whole plate of it. It's good.
Yeah, we're just trying to bulk up, you know? Because this is
you might have to make me some rice next
protein
time.
Protein and stuff, yeah. I was too lazy to make rice today, so just chicken. A plate of chicken. Is that weird?
Right, or is that ginger ale?
Ginger ale. But it's like Whole Foods ginger ale, so it doesn't really taste like a ginger ale, but a healthy ginger ale. It's pretty good.
Use my hot sauce.
Is it hot?
Try a little bit. It's hotter.
I'll try it on one piece of chicken.
Okay.
Oh. Sorry, I used the rest here.
I have 12 of these.
Okay.
Whoa. What?
I'm gonna go ahead and dip it. Taste test. It's like that hot wing show.
Yeah. Let's hot see. Ones with Rob.
It's not too bad.
Okay. All right.
Because, I mean, this is like not that hot. I just throw that on anything and I throw. Okay, yeah, I could feel that. What level is this? How do you eat this every day on everything?
Bro, that was from today. All that, the whole bottle.
Bro, Noah has like boxes of these just like stocked up. Like, dang, this guy really likes hot sauce.
Texas Pete, sponsor me, please.
No, really, you should get a Texas Pete sponsor. So yeah, we ran 7 miles and I got back. My leg, I could not walk on it anymore just because it hurt so bad. I don't know what it is. Something to do with tension, fluid buildup, lactic acid buildup maybe. I don't know if it was on my bones or just sore. Maybe I have chicken legs, Noah.
You should probably give up everything.
Should I just stop?
I think like why even work out?
Because like point? I was thinking of, like about really pursuing my fitness journey, but then I think I should just give up now after the whole leg thing.
I think your body's telling you like we can't do this.
I think my body's trying to tell me I can't do it, but my mind and my willpower is too strong to let that happen.
What are you gonna do about it?
So I could either sit down and cry about it, or I could compromise and maybe build some of my leg muscles up. Maybe I'm tired of being chicken leg Rob all my life. Hot sauce is it's a little hard to talk. We didn't continue the workout. We're supposed to do some boxing, but my legs couldn't handle anymore. We had to come back over here. We got in the shower, ate some food, and after I was sitting down for a minute, I tried to get up, and I was like, oh yeah. I had to sit back down. I had a little massager gun. I was muscle.
Nitty and grit.
Yep. I feel better. It still hurt, but we're gonna let my legs rest a little bit. Yeah. Tomorrow, I think we're gonna do some upper body until my legs feel better. Then I'm gonna start building my muscle on my leg. I think that's a good tactic.
Yeah, rest those legs.
Or maybe it's because I jumped into running when I never really did it before, and like now I do it. So like my legs are like, what are you doing, Rob? We don't run. We'll see where it goes. On another note, I think Noah has some news that I don't know if you want to tell the vlog yet. Ooh, or
let's do it.
Okay.
Yo, what's up, guys? So yeah, we were supposed to keep working out earlier. Rob is just getting beat up.
This has been happening to his leg a handful of times, so I'm actually concerned. Like, you might need to get that checked out.
Yeah, I'm thinking I probably need to get it checked out.
Adults, you have more knee problems because I think, what is it, the muscle slowly goes away and then it becomes more bone on bone.
Yeah.
I was telling Rob he might have like a parasite in there already eating away all the flesh. Hopefully not.
Hopefully that's not the...
Stretch it out and we'll see how it goes.
Yeah.
Other news. Yeah, guys, so by the time you're seeing this video, I have dropped my next song. It's called Feel This Good, featuring my friend Juice. He was in the When the Music Video Don't Match the Song 1, 2, and 3. And it's a love song. The songs that I've made in the past, everything's still mediocre. I don't claim to be a rapper, an artist, a writer. I'm just a guy that's trying to make entertaining stuff. And I think
you're constantly wanting to try to get better. And yeah, this is part of the journey.
That's how it is. What did Zach say in the other vlog? It was, you don't have to start to be great, but you have to be great to start.
You said it backwards though.
You don't have to be great to start, but you have to start to be great.
There that's it what it is. And I've started years ago and I'm still kind of like at this level. I've never really taken music serious at all because that's not something that I thought I would get into. And then we started making YouTube videos, and then I had friends that are making beats, and I was like, oh shoot, let me try to hop on one of these. I had a friend that had a studio. My friends were freestyling. I said, let me just try it out. Now I think I want to try to study it more and try to learn the whole science behind it and make stuff from experience that I have. So this love song was one of the first songs that are way different than what I've done before. All the other stuff I've done has been just the trap beats, because my method was, when I saw Lil Pump blowing up Smoke Perp, I was like, everybody just cares about the hard trap beats. As long as you have the hard beat, you can say whatever you want. So that's what I did. I just downloaded all the stuff off YouTube that was just trap, and I was like, I'm gonna just say anything. And that's what I did. I had some clever little silly bars here and there. I think I want to stay away from more of the trap songs in the future. I have 5 or 6 more trap songs already recorded, so I'm gonna have to post those and put those out in the future in the upcoming months. But by the end of this year, I think I'm gonna do like a 360 and try to do more storytelling and more experience-based music. This love song was one of the first ones where I tried it out. Not my strongest, but I still am proud about the song. My friend Juice killed it on the chorus, and he also made that beat. And I remember I went home in March, and I was like, yo, bro, send me some beats. He sent me some. And then I was like, wait, I remember that he told me he, like, sung and rapped back in the day. So I asked him, like, yo, you want to hop on this song real quick? Because I can't sing. I heard the beat, and I was like, oh, this is, like, somebody got to be singing on this, and I know I can't do that. So I had him, and he sent me that back, and I was like, oh, shoot, let's get to writing. So yeah, just a little love song. song, relatable, about a girl. Right now, if you go in the top of the description, you can stream it. You have Apple Music, Spotify, Google Play, Amazon. I think it's gonna be like a TikTok sound soon, so.
It's a vibe. It's a vibe. I like it a lot. It's new.
If you wanna make a TikTok to it, that could be cool. I honestly don't know. If you do listen to the song, I appreciate it. And tag me on Instagram if you just like listening to it, because I'm just trying to repost, and I just appreciate anybody that's watching this music journey that me, Rob, and Rhino are all gonna be on this new path to take over, because YouTube's fun, and I'm like, I feel like it would be kind of stupid to not just try out everything, right?
Yeah, you got to.
And if it doesn't work, okay.
Yeah, okay, like, then okay, at least you tried it.
I haven't put in the 10,000 hours. Let me put in some 10,000 hours on trying to write a song and maybe sing, maybe rap better, and then boom, maybe it can become something. But as of right now, it's fun to do. It's cool to just like go through the process. This song is a vibe. I think this fits with like the summer. A lot of people might think I'm a sim. They think it's just more chill, and it is just, it's a vibe. Go download the song, Field Is Good, right now in the description, and go watch the music video and let me know what you thought. Any updates on Rob's music career?
You trying to do any more music? I can't do another song with you though, because you keep outshining me.
False.
Continue.
Me and the music thing, I think as a creative.
Creative director.
I just like to create different things. Like Noah said, I'm not claiming I'm the best rapper. I see all the comments, you're just a YouTuber. What is
Stick
this?
Stick to YouTube.
Stick to YouTube. This is cringe. This is cringe. When I first started YouTube, it was bad. It was cringe. When I first started playing a sport that I was really good at one point, I was super bad. I needed so much practice. I know this is the same process. I'm not gonna be good at the jump, but I'm just having fun being creative, trying to get better as I go. I hope that you guys could appreciate the journey. I think that's the fun part. I'm not over here saying, yeah, I'm the best, I'm a rapper, this and that. I'm saying, I want you guys to be here with the journey, because one day I can be really good. Just like anybody can be really good at anything.
But if
they
say
do.
Stick to YouTube and stop making music, if you stop, then you'll never know.
Yeah, I'm just not letting that stop me.
And that's the thing, when you start anything new, you're always from people that be like, you can't do this, you can't do this.
Yeah.
They don't care till they see those results.
And try not to let those comments get to you guys, because I think that's what we try to do, just because that could really have an effect on how you think about yourself and whatnot. When you train yourself to think otherwise, like, I know I'm not at the level I want to be now, but in the future, if I work towards it, I can get to where I want to be. And that's the only way things are going to happen, if you take action. That's what I tell myself every day. I mean, I don't know all the answers. I don't know. I'm just doing what I think feels right and what's fun for me. But yes, new music on
coming
the way.
Soon, though.
Coming real soon.
Okay.
I'm almost finished writing my next one. It might be like the biggest, newest song on all the platforms. I don't know yet, but we'll see when it comes out.
And another quick tip, because the people that watch the vlog channel, I know you guys actually care about us. Y'all love us, and we love you guys for watching this. Mm-hmm. And seeing this family grow and this channel grow, it's so cool. For y'all that are watching this right now, for the song that I just dropped, and any song in the future for me, Rob, Rhino, everybody, can y'all like just make extra tabs on your computer and just like download YouTube replay loop and just like play my video like over and over, so we can just run the streams up? Like, that'd be lit if I could just get
this
a gold.
It's like fire anyway.
I would just want to get like a gold plaque. Like, just a flex in the video. Wait, how'd they get that? Little did they know.
Little did they know.
All 100,000 people maybe that are watching this video, everybody made one tab, looped my music video, and boom, now that's 100,000 times, let's say it only played 10 times. Boom, what's 500,000 for gold, and then.
I don't even know. I don't know anything about any of that.
All I know is Ricegum has a plaque. Why can't Rhino, Rob, and me have a plaque? So just go stream a song, even if you hate the song, like on your phone, play it, and then just like let it be. Or if you have another electronic device, like an iPad, play it on there. Or just send it to your friends and piss them off. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, and it's
everybody to click on it once.
And it's fun because you guys get to be a part of the journey. That's the fun part.
All I know is Joji blew up, Scar Lord. Who else from YouTube? DDG is basically.
Yeah, DDG is pretty mainstream.
And now it's Snowboat.
Now we're next.
Rob and Rhino. So go stream the song, guys. Just in case like the YouTube videos get demonetized, like I need to make sure I can still eat food. Yeah, stream the song, Field Is Good. Let me know what you thought. We got some more bangers on the way.
And since we're talking about music and running things up and stuff, I don't know if you guys even know that I make music. I don't think they know. Some people don't know.
They probably have no idea. They're like, wait, making new songs?
Yeah.
You made stuff?
I have a handful of songs already. You could check it out on Spotify or whatever, but I have like a music video called Bada Boom and No Sweat. None of them at a million yet. I wake up every day and I check my phone. Wish it was like at a million, but like, I understand that like a lot of people don't like to listen to that music.
That's just a concept. If you wanted to refresh a page or watch it, that's just an idea. I'm just throwing it out there. You don't have to do that.
Song Bada Boom, No Sweat. There's some other songs too. Just let me know.
Guys, my leg hurts and the only thing I want is just for you to listen to my song. Give me some feedback. It could be constructive. It could be bad. It could be good.
For Rob's leg, please.
For my leg. Thank you. One stream equals one leg.
One leg prayer.
Prayer.
Amen.
Thank you.
And look who joined us for our table talk.
Hey.
Go over there.
Yeah, let's go.
Table talk that we're not doing at the table.
Oh, you got the one sock on the bad leg?
This bad leg doesn't deserve to have a Rob sock on it.
So I know my hair is getting very similar to like a nest right now, but I'm working on trying to see what I can do. We're just gonna let it be right now.
Nice shirt.
Ryan will give it to me. I feel like everything I have is like passed down by other people.
Ready for this question? Where is the line between art and not art?
I think intention, maybe.
I was thinking about this when you go to art galleries and you look at random abstract paintings. Oh, anyone can do that. Well, why didn't you? And then there was one where it was a banana taped to a wall and it was like expensive or something.
I remember that.
So what is art and what is not art?
I never thought about
this before. Where's the line? And art is only worth what people are willing to pay for it.
If an artist did a painting and then I try to mimic it, it doesn't mean as much because I don't have that reputation.
I think art holds a lot of value with what you said, the reputation of the artist itself. Leonardo da Vinci has a reputation for paintings and art. I don't, so yeah. No one would buy my stuff. Would y'all buy my art if I painted something?
I would.
I'm gonna paint something. We not gonna do no painting on here.
Because I guess you could call anything art. The person that sewed this couch together, like that's an art form.
Next question. Is it possible to never tell a lie your whole life? I'd be telling all types of lies.
It's not possible.
No way.
People tell themselves lies all the time. You may not be saying it out loud, but you're thinking it.
Like when you're eating something you shouldn't eat.
Yeah.
You're doing something you shouldn't. It's okay.
You're lying to yourself. Oh, this is good for me right now. No, it's not.
Let's cut out your own mental lies. Lying to someone. And I'm not saying withholding information. So if this was $10,000 and it was mine and you stole it from me and I was like, oh my God, where's my $10,000? And you never said anything, you wouldn't be lying. You just were withholding the truth. But if I say, Rod, would you take my $10,000? No. Then you'd be lying. Is it possible to live a life without lying?
It's really hard. It might be possible for somebody, but I feel like that's such a thing that everyone does. It's such a natural thing, is it lying?
And then when you do something bad as a kid and your parents say, did you do this? No.
Yeah. When you're a kid, you don't really understand.
You kind of get trained to lie as a kid sometimes.
Yeah. Because you don't want to get in trouble or whatever.
What if someone confides in you, don't tell anyone this? Like if Noah says he has foot fungus, don't tell Rob that though. And you go, does Noah have foot fungus? He does. Yeah. Sorry, I have to, based on the questions, I can't lie.
That's an interesting concept.
How many lies do you think you've told your whole life?
I've told a lot of lies, but like...
only to protect people.
Then that's what I'm saying. It's like, what if somebody really came up to you and like asked you something and you knew the right answer, but you may have lied to maybe protect them?
That's completely valid.
I think that's okay. Like, there's white different
lies.
Ways to go
white
about
lies.
Things. White lies.
Why is it called a white lie? This is the problem with this nation. A white lie is okay. White is okay. Oh, the odd one out is a black sheep. I just got blackballed. The White House.
Blacking out. Wait, I think we're onto something.
That's a problem. I think I've seen more instances. I can't think of them right now, but have you ever had this situation? Did you ever screw everything up, but no one ever found out it was you?
And like, you didn't say nothing?
I'm trying to think. Yo, what happened to the thing? Oh my God, what happened?
I remember I used to spill things a lot, like as a kid, like spill drinks and stuff. Sometimes I'd be like, I don't know what happened. Like little things like that, I don't know.
It's nothing crazy, but I was at my grandparents' house and there was one of my cousins with me. He was like 3 years old. I went to the bathroom and on the way out I guess I locked the door and then closed it, so the door was now locked. And then my grandfather came over and was like, who locked the door? And I pointed to my three-year-old cousin Jeremiah. I said, he did it, he hurt him. And I was like, oh shoot. And then he was like crying. He was 3, so he didn't even know what was happening. I didn't do it. And he didn't even know that I did it, so he didn't even know why he was getting beat. But yeah, I just remember I locked the door and I blamed it on my little cousin.
This reminds me of, I was in high school, it was me and this kid named Casey, and we went into the bathroom during lunch. There was a kid in there taking a dump, and I thought it'd be funny to take a nickel and toss it into the stall and like hit him on the head or something, just because. So I did it, and then we ran out. Oh my God, oh my God. And then the guy that ran out was like this big jock, like football player. Like I was an absolute pipsqueak, Weenie Hut Jr. infant back in the day. And this guy was a big senior and I was a little freshman. He came out, who threw that thing? He came out fuming. And then he was like, did anyone see who threw that thing? And then a person saw us and he was like, oh no, it was some black kid and some Mexican. And Casey was like Italian. And I'm like not that dark. So it was like, he was probably looking for not the right people. Never found out.
Haha. What if he watches the vlog? We get a knock tomorrow?
You threw that nickel. And I don't know why I did that.
He still has the nickel.
You guys ever had food fights at your school?
Never.
No.
Oh, I had an epic one.
Yeah, shout out my high school, North Point High School, Waldorf, Maryland, DMV gang. You guys never had food fights?
Never.
No.
Not like the senior year one. You do it to the freshmen.
I only seen that in movies.
Food fight? No.
It was senior year. It was all the seniors that came up with the plan they were going to do a food fight. There was like the special two tables on top of the auditorium in the cafeteria where the seniors sat, and everybody else just kind of dispersed throughout the cafeteria. And I remember like the whole table, maybe like 8 dudes mixed with some girls. They took ketchup, they filled up a container with the fries, all ketchup, all mustard, and they just said, bonk, threw it back. just started launching them. And like, imagine that, 8 of those of ketchups and mustards and mayonnaise thrown at random people. And then the whole place went crazy. Administration didn't know what to do. And then like a little boy took burger, tried to throw it back at the seniors. And he hit one of the biggest seniors at my school. His name was Colin. He was like 6'6", big football player, dude. He got hit. I remember I was like, what's up, oh no. And this guy, you don't want to mess with this guy. They hit him, he went. Flipped 2 tables and then took all these chairs and just threw them back.
I thought it was a food fight. This guy left the furniture.
Right? He's not even throwing the right stuff. It was like a war, because I remember hearing girls cry, run. And I remember seeing a kid come out the bathroom with ketchup. Oh, I got hit. He had all the ketchup on him. Girls crying with mayonnaise in their hair. And it was chaos. And then I remember I went into like the multimedia room, threw the little glass, and we all just had the shades lifted up. And it was just people running back and forth. Then left the cafeteria, into the hallways, people throwing stuff from above, from the second floor to the bottom. And nobody could stop anybody because everybody was going crazy. It was chaos. So you guys never got to experience.
Never.
I got like a little bit of ketchup on my shirt, but I got back. It was funny seeing people cry about it. Like as if they were like, I got the mayonnaise.
Like lighten up. Like it's just some mayonnaise in your head.
La Plata was way too strict. I tried to do a promposal. All I was gonna do was go up on the stage and with my microphone and whatever. Principal wouldn't let me.
Now, when you were at school for lunch, did you have to stay in the cafeteria or could you walk all around school for the whole lunch?
We could walk all around school.
Same.
What?
Yeah.
Bro, we were confined to the pit.
And you only had a 30-minute lunch, right?
There was like 30-some minutes.
I had a whole hour. What'd you?
I had literally like almost an hour.
Yeah. Okay. You could eat anywhere.
Did anybody in your high school, like, not saying that I did this or anything, but there was like ketchup packets you get at the cafeteria. People would whisk them so it gets really tight and then toss them in the hallway so someone puts a little bit of pressure or steps on it, it just explodes.
Never seen that.
Really? Like, there was this twist the ketchup packet, toss it like a grenade in the hallway when everyone's walking passing period, and then people will step on it and it just explodes. I guess that was just a thing they did at my school.
I don't know.
I never did it.
I never did that.
Y'all were bad.
I did that once, but a lot of people did that at my school. More like freshman year, like barely getting into high school.
Did you have fights at your school?
Yeah.
How many fights?
The first high school I went to was a private school, so there was not much fights. It was like a private Catholic school. There's not that much fights or whatever.
I love Jesus more. The holy water.
When I went to a public school in high school, there was fights all the time. There was like some more rowdy kids there. I never got in any fights because I'm more of a lover, not a fighter.
You too busy loving the lovers, right?
Yeah, exactly.
We're the lovers. The lovers.
The lovers.
That's our group.
Lover boys. Lover boys.
Which could seem slightly sus because it's like
three dudes.
Three dudes. Yeah, we'll probably not do that one.
And then we all say the name in tandem. Lover boys.
We do one of these like a...
It's the lover boys. Probably not.
Yeah, that was a bad idea.
What's the most courageous thing you've ever done? Ooh, I don't really do anything. Ooh. Courageous?
You stopped that one bully.
I'm trying to think of something like meaningful.
I've definitely been courageous before. Courageous. Let's start using that word more.
I need a girl that's courageous. I don't like girls that think liking boba is a personality trait. Have you seen that?
Oh, yeah. Like on their profile or their bio.
I just want boba.
Boba is good though.
It's delicious.
I wouldn't say that's a trait, liking boba, but I do like boba.
I'm gonna start asking girls, what's like the most courageous thing you've done? Nothing.
Okay, we're done talking.
Yeah, go. What's everyone's favorite holiday? There's a few of them.
Christmas.
I think Christmas is number one for me.
Christmas. Not anymore.
Not anymore, but I want it to be back to how I felt about it when I was a kid.
My birthdays aren't even the same.
For real. I mean, that's a national holiday. My birthday, September 18th, so everyone knows.
Please clap.
Looking back on your life, childhood, would you have done anything differently? One thing, two things, it's easy to say.
I would say no. Because I feel like everything I did in the past led me to where I'm at now. But I think maybe if I'd done more or something differently as a child, I'd be in a different spot maybe. But that's hard to answer, I feel like. I don't know.
Would you, if given the chance right now, you can go back to being whatever age you want to be? A year ago, 2 years ago, you could be 10. No, and you know everything you know now.
Yes, I'll do that.
You would go through all the homework and test again.
No.
Right after the school,
I would drop out because I'd know all the lyrics to all the poppin' songs.
What's poppin'? Brand new whip just hopped in. I got options.
I'll be in middle school.
Back in the mail, let's go. You just have all these hits.
All these great songs.
But you wouldn't have the same access to everything because it wouldn't exist. So you couldn't look up the Baby Shug lyric.
No, but I know the lyrics now because you said I know everything.
Theoretically, you could prepare for the, here's my notebook, all the hit lyrics.
Yeah. So when the baby drops Suge, I'll be like, check the date, sir.
You're trying to tell the engineer, okay, start it out like, dun, dun, dun. Boy, you a fool for this one. What?
Trust me.
Right there, put it right there.
Yeah, I think I would.
That would be scary though. Like you're in middle school at 10, but you know you're 23, everything. You would sound crazy.
You would literally sound crazy.
I was given a choice to come back 10 years in the past. So I know everything. There's this guy named DaBaby, and he's a big rapper.
There's gonna be a global pandemic. Guys,
global pandemic.
Get the masks now. Get the sanitizer.
There's a Drake lyric.
You could be the Drake.
You could be Drake. In theory, you
in
could.
In theory, you do all the things he did.
But at that point, is it you anymore? Like, oh, if I went back in time, I could be a Viner. How would my career have changed from now until?
You could have became the ones that fell off.
I could have been the washed up Viner. I don't think I would do it.
I would.
You can go to any time though. You can go to 1 year ago. Would you relive the past year of your life?
But the past year of my life has been one of the best, I do gotta say.
I can only think of like one thing if I wanted to go back. Cause Rob already did it. There were many sports that my parents put me in at a young age. And I remember I just like quit all of them. I went to like 2 games, 2 practices, 1 season. I wish I could have been good at basketball. I remember being on a basketball team for like 1 season, and it was like the 3rd game, and everybody on the team was really good and I sucked. So I remember I hid in the closet game day with my jersey on. My parents were like, where is he at? I was just like, I don't want to play. And they came in and I broke down and said, I don't want to be a basketball player. I'm not good. I didn't understand like you had to pay for that type of stuff. So that's why my parents are mad that they wasted that money. They tried to get me to do like travel soccer. And I remember I went to one of the tryouts, super hot outside, and I was just too hot. So I laid on the bench and acted like I was sick. And then it was also like $200 for the whole week or whatever that I was supposed to be there. And I gave up, had a day too. Never learned any foot skills. Never fulfilled basketball. And my parents played basketball at like 5. I really did half a season and gave up. So I think the sports aspect, I wish I would have just done everything. I could have been a pro athlete. But if I go back in time, would I do it? I don't know.
I mean, I think about the butterfly effect of the second you change one thing in your life.
Messes everything up.
If I would go back like, oh, I want to score that goal against Northern, whatever. I knew I could have scored that one. And I go back and score it. And then who knows of what my life would become at that point.
Yeah, what happens if I became a basketball player, 5th, 6th grade. And then the school that did it better in middle school, I went there and I never met him.
Yeah, then it wouldn't exist.
And then I become great up till 12th grade at basketball and that's it.
But then it like never amounts to anything.
Right. I played in college. Wasn't good enough for the NBA. And then just cut short. Ooh, that's scary. But you said if I could pick any time, maybe I picked it like, I think I would go to like high school.
Yeah, day. I wouldn't go back too far. Cause I like my childhood. I feel like I did a lot.
I've already had the YouTube established.
Yeah.
Go back 1 year. Ryan, there's this guy named Mr. Beast. Look here. If we count to 1 million right now, we can blow up before him.
I found the Drake lyric. In his song entitled 6 p.m. in New York. Some nights I wish I could go back in life. Not to change. Just to feel a couple things twice.
Being able to even feel one memory to like just feel that again would be.
Oh, that would be.
What is a memory that y'all would like feel again? Or it could be a few. Many of soccer tournaments I went to, scoring goals and like some soccer games that I had right after I score the game winner and stuff. Those feelings are like some of the best, most euphoric, like glorious. Nothing on my plate, like nothing to do except play and be a winner. Stuff like that. Elementary school, Valentine's Day party, Halloween party. Feeling that would be awesome. The year before high school soccer, like doing the open gyms, those were cool. And I could name out too many.
There's just too much.
There's so, because now I got memories from childhood, a couple years ago, high school, flashing through my head.
The meetups, like the meetups at the
That first meetup we did, that feeling, it happened so fast that it also felt like the longest experience of my life.
Yes.
And then you couldn't even appreciate it until like a week later, like, whoa, we did that. In that moment, kids like swarming you, everybody trying to take a picture. Oh, that's crazy.
It still doesn't feel real knowing that that happened. And the whole day I was on this weird high of like, I didn't know how to feel that all those people came to see us. It's magical.
So when is another one gonna happen?
Bro, man, this Rona thing, I'm getting angry. We're leaving though, right?
We're gonna leave right now?
Yeah, where are we going?
Where are you going? Cause Noah's going.
Yeah, I'm gonna be going to South Carolina for about 4 days.
I'm going to Laughlin and Utah.
I might have to go somewhere.
Might have to.
I'll go to different.
And we all like iPhone vlog some stuff.
Bro, that would be a lit vlog.
And all right, let's see what Ryan's doing.
Catch up with Ryan,
What's up
with Noah.
What's up guys? Would y'all want to see that if all of us went somewhere and just vlogged it, but not together?
Separate with different people. Oh, that'll be good.
Crazy. Who gets the camera?
I mean, I could bring mine.
Show a camera.
Yeah, and
I know Ryan will forget to film anything on his iPhone. Ryan can take the camera.
Yeah.
I'll use my iPhone. Because I'm going to go on some jet skis and stuff, and I'll be okay. We'll give the camera to Ryan.
Ooh,
I have another camera anyways. So we all get a camera.
We're lit.
We're good. In theory, we are risking ourselves. ourselves because we're going to get on the plane.
There's not gonna be anybody on the plane though.
Is there?
Actually, I'm driving to my destination, but yeah,
you guys driving to Utah? How far away is that?
Just 8 hours.
8 hours.
What type of car is it?
It's a van.
They're making you drive?
I'm not driving. I'm chilling. I'm not driving. No. Okay.
What's the right age to get married?
There's no right age to get married. There's no right or wrong answer to that. Right?
Correct. What age do you think you're gonna get married?
What am I, 24 right now? Hopefully by like late 20s, 28, 29, or with somebody at least.
29
married? I think you'll rethink that when you get 29.
I don't know. My future wife could be watching this right now. If my future wife's watching this, I love you.
I think our first job is to get a girl to like us.
That's step one.
Have you got past step one?
I thought I have a couple times, but we're still working on it.
Here's the thing about girls.
Are you really gonna say it?
You know what? I'm about to say it. How many times have you been in a situation where a girl said, oh, yeah, and then I'll let you know and we'll hang out. After the weekend, when I'm coming back from my aunt's place, I'll hit you up.
Yeah, that's happened to me a few times.
It happens to me all the time. Girls don't care. They like the attention. They like just talking and willy-nilly and blah, blah, and then they just discard.
I do not believe in love.
Because it's so easy for girls to get guys, I feel like. Mm-hmm. Then guys to get girls, that's harder.
Well, because if guys are the hunters, they're just waiting their turn, right?
Yes. Yeah. I don't know how much in depth we've talked about this in this vlog channel, but women and females are always the prize, and there's so many men that want to be with them, and here's the world, and here's money, and here's everything you need. So women have a sense of entitlement, because when you're constantly getting treated, if I'm pampering you, Rob, and giving you grapes, and here, Rob, do you need anything? Do you need a foot, Rob? I love you. I'll do anything to be near you. You would get used to that and you would start expecting it. Then if somebody didn't give you that normal treatment, you'd be like, hey, give me that treatment. Again, that's how you get girls, is not giving them what they always getting from other guys. Women are given such high praise. I mean, obviously women are amazing. We're talking about girls our age, not like moms. Girls our age are just constantly complimented. There's a clear reason why men and women don't get the same treatment with each other, is because men, we're not treated with, oh, here's all this great stuff. We have to work for it and do all this stuff. Women are just,
yeah, I think a lot of things do come easier for women, but still women have a lot of things that they have it harder than men on some things.
Yeah, certain things in society are harder for men, certain things are harder for women, but in terms, I think, of relationships solely,
oh yeah,
we're talking about girls from the age range of drinking age plus like 20s can walk into any bar. Who here wants to leave with me? Everybody there is going to be like, me. I go in there, ladies. Crickets. People looking away, looking at their phones.
Or you bring a lady with you and then they leave you.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was a good one, Noah. Yeah, I asked for that one. I'm recovered. I don't even think about that no more. I unfollowed her on Instagram.
You think she's seen this?
No, she does not.
She's not watching this.
Did she ever hit you back, though?
No.
Her loss.
There are so many bad guys out there that give other guys a bad rap. So we're not even going to talk about that. I'm talking about girls. Call Cassidy of her to do that to you.
Pretty disrespectful.
Like, all gender aside, who do you think you are to treat me like that?
Drop her name and address right now, Rob.
Fine, it's...
And the same with our video about people talked how they texted. These girls leaving on people on red. I'm not gonna respond to you. Yeah, I'll be there. We can hang out this weekend. Oh, just kidding, I'm not gonna text you. How dare you?
Got my beard growing out. All I'm saying is that I'm glowing up or whatever they call it.
I'm done tolerating disrespect.
You should be too.
I'm pretty tired of it.
Imagine the people that you're watching this right now and you got a little love interest and you're not texting me back though. Stop it.
And everybody, when we said this, all the girls in the comments, who broke y'all's heart? Why y'all feel like that?
Y'all, girls be doing it. The only reason girls act the way they do is because guys help facilitate the cycle of, I'm gonna pamper you and princess. And then I come up, nice guy. Hey, beautiful. Accept me. And they're like, go. Here, ma'am, here's $10,000 for you.
Thank you.
Now spend some time with me. They don't do it. You're already getting too pampered.
They know what they can get and they just know. I don't know. I'm not a girl. I don't know these things.
Oh, and then y'all saw the thing on Twitter. It was like, first off, what is that thing where it says Bumba Clot?
Bumba Clot.
It's a
Jamaican term.
I've read it on Urban Dictionary once. It says it's used as an insult or interjection expressing disgust or anger.
Huh?
They did a Bumba Clot, whatever, and then it was a picture of a cartoon. A guy there and his girl was on FaceTime and they had fallen asleep together. Someone said, remember that person you were asleep on FaceTime with? Where are y'all now? Exactly, but don't waste your time. Isn't that true? Have y'all ever had like FaceTime with a girl and you're, and fall asleep or not?
I've definitely done that.
I think the ones that I fell asleep on FaceTime with for like 5 days in a row are the ones that broke my heart.
Any of the girls that you guys fell asleep on FaceTime with, are you with them now or do you communicate with them at all now?
Here's the thing. I read another tweet. It says the people that text each other after 12 a.m. and do FaceTime calls are the ones that catch the hardest feelings.
What time is it? 12:11.
Putting my phone away.
You're not gonna get me, girl.
Oh, I'm the one that catches feelings. They don't.
They both do.
Because if you're up together, there's clearly some more.
And you go to sleep thinking about
like
that.
You guys both could be asleep right now, but I really like you. Talk to me. I'm texting you. I'm calling you. Which is equivalent to, I guess, going to sleep because you guys are spending that last little bit of time.
And do you think that's healthy?
Doing that, like FaceTiming late at night.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. To our point, we just explained, where are those people now? That I don't speak to any of them. We're not in communication. All the people that, I care about you so much.
We already said it in a Loveless Earthscape. Don't worry about them. Focus on yourself.
Focus on yourself and then it'll come. We're not preaching separatism here. We're just saying value yourself first. The end. People are ruthless at the end of the day. Guys are ruthless and mean to girls. Girls are ruthless and mean to guys. Emphasis on that. It goes both ways. Just focus on yourself.
What is this?
Fashion Nova.
That's Noah's.
Look.
I got a couple of face masks. Okay. Look, they're pretty dope. Wait, look at one of them. Look. 85% off. Shout out Fashion Nova. Not sponsored.
Was this like a mystery pack they just send you? Oh, and we didn't get depicted as a
He gets like the membership box every month with new masks.
I didn't look at what I got that day. There was like a box for like 5 or 6. I said, add to cart. I can be safe in fashion.
They gave you like the third grader designs.
No, I picked that.
I don't know what designs they had for his options. I had my mom make me black ones. These are cool.
Wear your masks.
Just stream my new song, link in the description.
It's running up.